Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing well. So today's video is going to be one that's probably long overdue. I keep saying that I'm going to do a wedding update and it's been like 2 months and I haven't done it yet. So this video is going to be everything about the wedding. We got engaged on the 28th of April this year. 28th, it wasn't. 22nd of April this year. And I'll actually leave the vlog linked below because it was a bit of a surprise. We were on holiday in Nerja, Spain, and Andy proposed. I say it was a surprise. We'd been together 8 years, so we had spoken about it before. He knew I was going to say yes, but I didn't know that he was going to ask me on holiday or that we were going to start planning or anything like that. So yeah, it's all been a bit of a whirlwind since then because we decided to get married pretty much straight away and we got everything booked within like a month. I thought I would give a bit of an update and tell you a bit about why we're doing that and how we're saving money and what we're doing about having a small ceremony and stuff. Yeah, so when Andy first proposed, our first idea was to get married abroad and we wanted to hire a villa, rent a villa in Portugal, which is where we go every year. I've went there every year since I was like 3 or 4, maybe twice a year sometimes, and I just love Portugal. And the villa that we were in last year was actually the perfect wedding venue, and I even said that to Andy, if we were ever getting married abroad, it would be here because it had like a lovely little courtyard where you would do the ceremony, and then it had like little different areas where you would have like a barbecue, and then I thought like we'll do a really relaxed thing and have like people can sit by the pool and have a barbecue and everything after the wedding. That was the original plan. But after a couple of days looking online for prices and trying to plan it, we just realized that it's too far away. See, to plan something that far in advance for me is torture because you just don't know what's going to happen in a year's time, and I feel like it's almost tempting fate to book something so far in advance because you just don't know what's going to happen by then, and you don't want to book something and commit to it and then a year in advance everything's different and you wish you'd done something simpler. So yeah, I kind of talked myself out of it, and I didn't want to ask friends and family to go there what was essentially a really, really small ceremony. Once we got home and talked about it, we realised that all we really wanted was something small, and I looked online at different places in Glasgow. We realised like we're not really that bothered about having a big wedding. Neither me and Andy have like dreamed about having a huge wedding or anything before, so it really wasn't important, and I don't like to be the centre of attention. If we had a wedding and I was to like walk down an aisle and do like a first dance and sit at a top table, like that's not my thing. I couldn't, like I cringe so easily at things, and I don't think I would enjoy it. Plus, I feel like since I'm not a wedding-y person, I've never really looked forward to having a big wedding. It would just feel a bit daft to do that just because that's like what's expected of you. So yeah, we both agreed, let's not do a big wedding, let's do something really small. We decided that because it was going to be a small wedding, there's no point in waiting until next year. We could really do it in the next few months. And I didn't even really want to wait until winter. I thought it's better just to have a summer wedding, and yeah, because it was going to be a lot cheaper than it would be for having a big wedding, we thought why not just do it in August. We looked around and I found a place called The Bothy. I'll leave the link below for the vlog where we give you like a little tour of it. That was our first time seeing it and I absolutely loved the place. It's a room, like a private dining room. It's got a huge big dining table and it's all really nice, like rustic and decorated already. Like there's dried flowers everywhere and there's so much there's so much detail in the whole room and it just doesn't need to decorate it. They've got a lovely like platform thing, what would you call it? Like a big wooden thing that hangs from the ceiling and it's got all loads of candles and stuff on it. It's just lovely. Totally the style that I was looking for, and as soon as I saw it I was like, this is definitely where I want to get married. But it's like a dining room, but they actually do, it's called Wee Weddings, and they do the wedding at the top of the table. So there's a huge big fireplace and you just kind of stand at the top of the table and all your friends and family are sitting down for dinner. Obviously dinner's not out yet, but everyone's sitting down and you get married at the top of the table and then sit down and all have a really big meal together and a drink, and you can do whatever you want after. So we decided that was perfect. We asked what days were available and we got our date in August, which is really exciting. The next thing we had to decide was who to marry us. So we looked online, you can either get a registrar or a humanist, or obviously if you wanted a religious ceremony, I don't know how that works, but me and Andy aren't religious anyway. So we decided to get a humanist. In terms of money, I think it's going to cost around £1,000 for the meal, and that is for 24 people plus Oliver and my niece, who isn't even born yet, she's only going to be 8 weeks or something then. That's what we'd be paying for the meal. And then for the actual person to marry us, we have got a humanist and they charge, it's about £400 or £500, which I was like, oh my god, that is ridiculous. But that seems to be like the norm. That's what I've realised with wedding stuff, like everything is expensive. Even when you're trying to do it on a budget. So there was the option of either getting a humanist or a registrar, and the registrar is a little bit cheaper. I think they're about £300, but they are very like by the book. That's so I've heard anyway. They will just do like the legal thing and be on their way. Whereas if you get a humanist, they will do like kind of make it more of a ceremony and then like talk a bit about how you met, talk about your families, and just make it a bit more special, I suppose. So we thought, see, since we don't have like an aisle to walk down and we don't have anything else that's like a traditional wedding, let's just get a humanist that can at least like lead the room a bit and make it feel a bit more wedding-y. In terms of other things that we're doing, we are getting our invitations by Viola's. That is a lovely like wedding stationery company. It's owned by my sister-in-law. I'll leave it linked below. Her wedding invitations for her own wedding were phenomenal. She just has so much attention to detail. So there was no question I was going to get her to do the wedding invitations. We are going to be sending invitations to everyone that's coming to the meal and make that more of the wedding-y thing. And then afterwards, we've actually booked out a venue for that's more of like a pub so that we can just invite all our friends to go there, because obviously we can only have 24 people. That's actually over capacity. They normally only have 22 and we're pushing it a bit and having 24 plus two babies. Unfortunately, we can't have like all our friends there at the meal. So we're going to just have a party straight after. After we've had the meal and a few drinks with our family, we're going to head over to the pub, meet everyone else and just have a bit of a drink. But we're only sending invitations to the people that are doing that are coming to the meal, because I feel like that's the formal part. I'm going to text everyone. I'm going to put it on Facebook, on a Facebook like private group thing. I know that will make some wedding-y people cringe, but I'm not going to send an invitation to like an extra 60 people when I could just text them. It's not a big deal. So yeah, that's the way that we're saving money. We're only sending the invitations to people that are coming to the actual ceremony. Everyone else will be coming to the nighttime part, which is more like a night in a pub. You don't get an invitation when you're going to a friend's like birthday party and stuff, so I don't see why they need it for this. The only other things that we have organised are a photographer. I'm using the same photographer that my sister used and that my brother used, called Carol. Can't remember his second name. He's on Instagram. He's really, really good. So we booked him for 2 hours. We're going to get him to take photos of the ceremony and then like some photos afterwards. And then obviously I'll have my camera out and be taking loads of photos for the rest of the night as well. So the only other thing that I really have to organise is the decorations, which I think I'm using a company called Lavender and Rose Events on Instagram. They're going to be doing my bouquet and my decoration for down the middle of the table, kind of think like a table wreath thing, but I'm not having any bridesmaids. I did get asked that. I just thought, because we don't actually have an aisle to walk down, it just seems a bit daft to have a bridesmaid, like they wouldn't have anything to do. And even for a best man, like it's literally just going to be me and Andy standing at the top of the table, so there just isn't really anything for anyone else to do. Me and Andy are just going to walk in ourselves, everyone will be sitting down, that'll be it. So it just felt a bit daft to make it more weddingy when it's just not, it's just not going to suit the style that we've got. So no bridesmaids, obviously that saves a lot of money as well. We're not having like a groom's party or anything like that. Andy is getting a kilt, which he's hiring, which he really, really likes, and I really like it as well. I still don't have a dress. I talk about this all the time on Instagram stories. I'm really struggling to find a dress that I like. I did look at getting one made because so many people had recommended getting one made, and there's two designers, dressmakers I spoke to, and I don't know, I just feel really nervous about it because I don't know anyone that's actually had a dress by them. So I've never had a dress made before, and the thought of having one made for me and then me trying it and not liking it but still having to pay for it is terrifying. Yeah, I have actually ordered a dress from Debenhams. I'm not going to tell you what it's like just now because I might do a bit of a try on if I order more of them. But yeah, I've ordered a dress from Debenhams. I'm going to try it on and hopefully I like it and that'll be that situation done. But yeah, other than a dress, there's not really anything else I need to do. I need to do favours actually. That's something that I need to decide on because I'm not sure what I'm going to do. Someone did ask in fact about wedding DIYs. I don't think I'm going to do it because I just feel like I don't have time. I did do some lovely DIYs for my sister's wedding, which I still have some of them, but I just feel like I've done those ideas and I wouldn't really want to do them again. And yeah, I don't think I'm going to do any wedding DIYs this year. This year, as if I do like a wedding every year. Also, I just realised that I never showed you my engagement ring. This is it here, and I had to get it smaller twice because it felt too big for me, and it still does feel a bit big. But it's just a very simple, like, single stone, which I've always told Andy I just wanted something simple, so he remembered that. I've got no painted nails. But yeah, it's weird because I'm just so not used to wearing jewellery. I never normally wear jewellery other than a necklace, so yeah, but I really, really love it. Also, I still need to get a wedding ring. God, that's another thing on the list, actually. Let me know if you want to see any other wedding videos. If you'd like to see, like, a wedding dress try-on haul, then do let me know, because I think I'd quite like to order some from, like, High Streets and do a bit of a try-on. And yeah, any other wedding updates will be in my Insta stories. So I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. I hope it's not been too rambly. I never really do videos like this. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. Give it a thumbs up if you did, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!